Welcome in to Enemy Sidelines, presented by Microsoft Teams. Our guest this week is New England Patriots team reporter Megan O'Brien. Megan, welcome in. I know it's been a roller coaster of a season for those Patriots. They lose four in a row, and then we saw that huge upset victory they had against the Baltimore Ravens on Sunday night. Is the mood a little bit more optimistic in New England these days?
I think it has to be, especially when you beat a team like the Ravens. Now, the Patriots were able to string two impressive offensive performances together, and I think it's almost as if it's a new season in Foxborough. This win against the Ravens has given the Patriots new life, and I think they're riding that high and looking forward to the next opponent, which is obviously the Houston Texans.
I read this stat that Bill Belichick is undefeated when his team is the underdog by a touchdown or more. So with that being said, what is it about his teams and how he coaches that they play not only so well, but they can win under pressure like that?
Well, I think when you look at the last 20 years, there haven't been many games where Bill Belichick's team has been an underdog by 7 or more points because of the dominance that the Patriots have had through the last 20 years. And it really is remarkable. But I just think looking at the coaching job that the Patriots staff put together this week to go up against the Ravens, they had 17 players on the injury report, Friday's injury report heading into the week. And several of those players were on the front seven. And what do the Ravens like to do? Well, they like to run the ball. And the Patriots did an excellent job containing that run. And I think Bill Belichick just looks at each week as another building block opportunity. The Patriots were slowed down a little bit in the beginning of the season due to a slight COVID outbreak when Cam Newton tested positive for COVID. Then Stephon Gilmore did as well. They were back out on the practice field, stringing days together, building upon that. And I think this win, like I said, gave them new life.
Yeah, you mentioned Cam Newton with the COVID diagnosis, and he went through a month there where he did not have a passing touchdown. He was still rushing for touchdowns, but it was really slow going, it seemed like, for Newton early on in the season. Where do you think that he has really shown the most growth or the most progress since his return from COVID and even throughout the season?
I think for the Patriots, it's been about developing an identity under Cam Newton as their quarterback. Without training camp this year, without Cam Newton being available for some of those early weeks of the season, without the team being able to practice, it was tough for them to really install new things, to develop their offensive identity. You can do those things virtually over Zoom meetings or whichever way you want, but it's different when you're not physically able to be together and practice those things. Cam Newton has had to learn a whole new offensive system with new offensive weapons. And I think it's just taken him some time. Now, getting back to those weapons, he doesn't have a ton to work with, but I think the chemistry he's built with wide receiver Jacoby Myers is certainly promising. And N'Keal Harry, he's been dealing with a concussion. He was back out this week. Hopefully Harry can take a step forward. And then Edelman, who's on IR, it sounds like at some point he will come back this season. It won't be this week against the Texans, so you don't have to worry about Julian Edelman.
Yeah, but let's just rest him a little bit longer.
I think the progress of the offense, it keeps evolving, and that all starts with Newton.
All right, so according to our next-gen stat presented by AWS, Cam Newton ranks second in the NFL with 9 rushing touchdowns. Only Kyler Murray has more with 10. So with that being said, how has Josh McDaniels really adapted this offense to fit Cam's mobility and his skill set?
Well, there's no question. They are a run-first offense, and I think you have to pat the offensive line on the back. They did a tremendous job against the Ravens under less than ideal situations there, and they've created the lanes for Damian Harris. They've allowed Cam to run, and I think that it all really begins with the run for the Patriots. I mentioned the weapons, how they don't have a lot to work with. I think if the Patriots can establish the running game, things will open up for the Patriots offense.
All right, so let's talk about that Patriots running game, because obviously you don't have Sony Michel for the season, but you've got Damian Harris, you've got Rex Burkhead. So how are those two used in tandem, and how are they used in different situations for the Patriots run game?
Well, the Patriots will have to make a decision this week on whether to activate Sony Michel off of IR or not. So there is a question there and something to keep an eye on, because he could add some more depth. He had an underwhelming season last year in his second year playing in the NFL, but Michel could add some promise, especially running behind this offensive line. Now, Damian Harris is a second-year player who's made the most of all of his opportunities. He was dealing with an injury last year. He was dealing with an injury at the beginning of the season. But after this last performance he had, it seems like he is the lead back, unless Sony Michel comes back and has something to say about it. Rex Burkhead has been the offensive MVP for this Patriots team. And I think the key with Burkhead is his versatility. He can run the ball out of the backfield. He can catch. He made himself a great touchdown reception when quarterback Jacoby Myers threw him the ball in that trick play on Sunday. But Rex Burkhead really has been the heart and soul of this offense. He does it all. But one thing I would keep an eye on is James White. James White has been a key contributor for the Patriots over the past several years. He hasn't been playing as much this season. Obviously, he was dealing with a terrible tragedy, and that kept him out of a couple of games. I don't know why James White hasn't been playing as much, but anytime he's out there, he contributes as well. So I think those group of versatile backs have really helped the Patriots offense and gotten more production.
Well, you mentioned receivers, but you've got a pretty good receiver on that defensive side of the ball. Cornerback J.C. Jackson's interception in the closing seconds of the second quarter against the Ravens was his sixth pick of the season. He's got five consecutive games with an interception. That just seems crazy, but it's a new franchise record. What's been the key to his success, and how does he get his hands on a pick every single week?
What's been most impressive about Jackson is the way he's stepped up and filled the void for Stephon Gilmore. The Patriots have been without Gilmore for the past three games. And in that game against the Jets, Jackson and the rest of the Patriots secondary did not play well, yet Jackson was able to come up with a crucial interception. And it seems like he's there for all the big plays. He's a young player. He's still developing. Seems sometimes he gets a little handsy and draws some penalty flags, but he's definitely cleaned it up and he's got a knack for the ball.
All right. So Stephon Gilmore, what can you tell us about him? Obviously you've got a lot of injuries that you've been dealing with. You got a lot of COVID cases this season, but what about his status for the rest of 2020?
Yeah, that is something that's been very curious to watch about the Patriots. Stephon Gilmore was dealing with a knee injury, and there were reports that after the injury occurred in practice that Gilmore had an MRI done and they didn't find the injury to be significant. However, Gilmore has not been out at practice. He was out for a walkthrough last week, but besides walkthroughs, he hasn't been on the practice field and he hasn't been seen in game action. Now, that was a name that was floated around a lot at the trade deadline. And obviously, he's still on the Patriots team, but it is curious that he hasn't been out on the practice field or active for games.
All right, how surprising is it? Because when the season started, it seemed like the Patriots had the longest list of players that were opting out due to COVID concerns. And you lose starters like Deonte Hightower, Patrick Chung. You know, who's really stepped up or surprised you in the absence of some of those leaders on the team?
I think Jacoby Myers has been the biggest surprise because he was an undrafted player and he's really stepped in, didn't have an opportunity until N'Keal Harry was injured. And then Jacoby Myers has definitely made the most of his opportunities. But I also look at a guy on the defensive side of the ball like Adrian Phillips. He was signed as a free agent for the Patriots and he's really made the most of that. He's a versatile player. He's been playing that safety and really kind of filling in for that Patrick Chung role. And another name that I would watch out for is Kyle Duggar, who's a rookie second round pick for the Patriots. We know the Patriots are sort of notorious for that rookie redshirt year. And it didn't seem like Duggar was getting a lot of opportunities at the beginning of the season. That all changed in the game against the Ravens. And Duggar was very impressive. He led the team in tackles. I would look for him to build off of that performance as well. But the tandem of Duggar and Phillips, to me, is really the key of the defense just because of the speed that they provide.
Okay. Well, it seems like every year these two teams face each other. And, you know, we reminisce about all the Patriots connections on the Texans team and vice versa. But this year seems a little different because it's Romeo Crennel as interim head coach, and Romeo and Bill Belichick's relationship has gone back many, many years. I wrote a story about it on HoustonTexans.com, like the sheer experience of the NFL between those two coaches, and they were together with the Giants. Obviously, they're together with the Patriots, but What has Bill Belichick been saying about facing Romeo Crennel, a guy that he's coached with on multiple teams and is really good friends with? They have it's different from the coaches that have worked under him. They were really working side by side for a lot of their careers early on.
Well, it's interesting, DP. I'm not sure if you knew this, but this will be the oldest coaching matchup in the history of the NFL when you look at Crennel and Belichick. Belichick pushing 70, he's 68, and Crennel in his 70s. But these two just have a wealth of football experience. When Coach Belichick spoke about Crennel this morning, he just said he's a guy who's inspiring to his players, a great teacher, and finds a way to get the most out of everyone. And you look at those guys with all of their experience, everything that they've proven, and they still find a way in today's NFL, which is a lot different from the NFL from 10 years ago, the NFL from 20 years ago, but they still find a way to get their players to learn, to improve, and to produce.
And they've been through some crazy seasons, a strike, a lockout, a pandemic. I mean, they've pretty much been through it all, and will be fun to see. I feel like Romeo always skews that age, the factor for coaches heading to kick off every week. Megan, always a pleasure chatting with you, and look forward to chatting some more after. Let's hope for a win, I guess, for the Texans, not so much for you guys, but always a pleasure chatting with you anyway. Megan, let's catch up again soon, shall we?
Thanks, DP.